You're not going to want to miss the next episode of the AI Show, where we talk all about responsible AI support for images and text models, a two-parter. Make sure you tune in. Hello and welcome to this episode of the AI Show. We're talking all about responsible AI support for images and text models, a two-parter, one for text, one for images. I've got my friend Wenxin. How you doing, my friend? Tell us who you are and what you do.
Awesome. I'm doing good. Thank you, Seth, for asking. I'm really excited to join this show with you.
Fantastic. So for those that don't know what the responsible AI dashboard is, can you give us a little elevator pitch?
Of course. The Responsible AI Dashboard is a single pane of glass that brings different open source tools such as error analysis, model explanation, and fairness metrics all together in Azure Machine Learning. So previously, we have the Responsible AI Dashboard for tabular data, where you can use it for classification or regression models. And now we are expanding the support to models trained on image and text data for different scenarios like image classification, object detection, and text classification scenarios.
That's amazing. And so can you give us a little summary of what that might mean? I have a slide here.
Yeah, so like imagine you are working on an object detection model. You may encounter issues like misalignment of bounding boxes, object overlap, or spurious correlations. Or when you are working on like a text classification model, the model does not focus on right parts of the text to make prediction. In this case, the new dashboard can then help you to identify, measure, and mitigate this issue with our rich visualizations, metadata support, and also enable the entire human-in-the-loop debugging experience.
That's cool. And so this is what all of this new stuff that we're talking about, all of this rich visualizations, metadata support and ingestion, really, this is all part of the new stuff. Is that right?
Of course. And as you can see here, we also adding the new interpretability for vision and text. So we are integrating the open source explanation method as SHAP vision and SHAP test, which is model agnostic. And we also developed the DRISE explanation for object detection models in collaboration with Microsoft Research. And the entire user experience is consistent with what we have previously with the tabular data. So it's very consistent and you can debug your workflow by yourself.
That's amazing. So I thought maybe we could spend some time looking at how this works. Do you have a second to do that?
Yeah, of course. Here is how you can generate the RAI dashboard for text. So the dashboard is generated from Python SDK or CLI. You can bring your natural language processing model, register it via MLflow, and add this RAI text insight component to generate it. Here is an example of the demo we are going to show today. So we use the ESG text classification model as an example. So this example classifies the ESG report into well-classified topics within environmental, social, and governance practices. So this pipeline actually adding this RAI text insight component to the Hugging Face model we trained for. So now let's move to the dashboard. When we land into the dashboard, we will see the error analysis component first. This will help us find out where the model makes the most mistakes and what are the blind spots based on the features and metadata we extracted from the model, such as the positive, negative words, or sentence lengths. In this case, we see that while the overall error rate is 17%. The error rate can go as high as 33% for those paragraphs that are not too long and have fewer positive words. So for the future investigation into this erroneous cohort, we can save this as a cohort and name it error cohort. So moving on to the second component, which is model overview, we can quickly see the model performance. It performs very well on the environmental topic like climate change or natural capital, which has the accuracy rate about 90%. So for the climate change, it has 97%. While the model performs really bad when the true label is non-ESG, which has a lower 50% of accuracy rate. We also observed that the environmental topics makes up the majority of the example, while the non-ESG data is having a smaller sample size. So I'm also curious to see more pattern around where this misclassification happens. So let's look at the confusion matrix. We can see that the majority of misclassification happens when the model wrongly predicted non-ESG data to fall under an ESG category. We can further diagnose why this happened with the next component. From the data analysis component, there is a table view and a chart view to see the pattern and the distribution of your data. And from the error analysis, we know that the model performs worse when it has fewer positive words and shorter sentence lengths. So we can use this scatter plot. We can use this scatter plot to identify why. By changing the x-axis, let's use the sentence length as an example here. And we can also change the x-axis to the classification outcome to see the error distribution. And by changing the color value, you will see better visualization here. So from the scatter plot, we can confirm our previous finding that the shorter length has a worse performance because the misclassified examples are in the lower half of the y-axis. This observation will lead us to focus on this example for the model debugging. Let's go to the feature importance dashboard to see how the model reaches predictions and understand its decision better. Here, it shows the top K important words in classifying text into a topic across the entire data set. Most of the words seem to relate to climate change or natural resource like discharges, metal, and it is consistent with the fact that these topics make up the majority of the examples and are better classified. Then in the individual feature importance dashboard, you can also look at a single example to confirm your intuition or drill down into arrows. Here, I want to show a correctly classified example. Let's switch to the old data first. So in this example, the model correctly classified the sentence as pollution and waste. So let's move to the feature importance here. And we can also change the class to pollution and waste, which is the correct label. So you can see here, like the top K important words are indeed related to pollution and waste, such as like waste, recycled, reused, materials. And you can also trace this work back into the context to identify whether it makes sense or not. And from this example, we can see that it seems to be consistent with the prediction from the context. So this type of consistency can add to our trust of the model. And in contrast, let's look at the incorrect example by switching to the erroneous cohort first. So this example wrongly classified the model from non-ESG to fall under the natural capital. So let's examine why. We can change this class to natural capital, which is the model prediction. So we can observe that the short input text has surface, metal, and palm, and this led the model to wrongly predict it to be fall under natural capital based on these words. Well, if we read this sentence, it seems to be out of context. So we did a data investigation into this data subset and find the mitigation method to take actions. So from the data, we know that this is because of the parsing of the PDF, and the model wrongly parsed this table content as a text sample, and it lost all the context about like EPAT. So some mitigation method will be like we can have better parsing of the PDF and include most of the context and ignore some of those food footage or the specific table content in the model. And another option is we can also use an image classifier first for this task. So just to sum up, I used a single pane of glass dashboard with variety of capabilities to measure and diagnose my errors and enhance my model accordingly. So to achieve that, the error analysis component helped me identify the cohort with higher error rate. And the model overview and confusion matrix help me understand the direction and type of error. And finally, the data analysis and feature importance component help me diagnose the issue better by better understanding my model decision. So overall, this component work together to help me pick the targeted mitigation and enhancement plan around my model. So that's the end of my demo.
That's cool. I have like 1,000 questions because there's so much cool stuff in here. Let's go back to the beginning on the actual code. And the first question I have as I'm looking at this, I'm talking about the first tab. So basically you've trained a text classification model into several categories. Am I getting that right? Is that right?
Yes.
So once you get that model, you're basically putting it into this RAI text insights component thing. Is that right?
Yeah, exactly. So this is a Azure machine learning component and where you can pass into your models. You can also pass into your test data. And once you are adding this text insight component, like all of the different components I just show will be automatically added to your model and generate this RAI dashboard.
I see. So once you run this, then that's when you get the stuff in the second tab.
Exactly. So this is what you are going to see offline. And this is a very, very clean example. Like you just need to bring your model, your data, and bring the RAI text insights.
Cool. And then the last thing you have is the actual output of the dashboard. Is that correct?
Exactly. So after you have run this entire pipeline, finish running, you can find this in your model page and you can go to your model page. You can see here, this is the model page. And there will be a responsible AI tab where you can access the responsible AI dashboard you just created.
And there it is. Well, Wenxin, this has been amazing. Thank you so much for spending some time with us. What's in the future for this type of text RAI dashboard?
So you can find out more about like how you can generate the text dashboard with the Microsoft Docs. And you can also find out how you can better understand the text dashboard with our documentation as well. And we are also going to have more support scenarios such as question answering. And of course, I know everybody is very enthusiastic about the large language model. And yes, we are working on that. We will have more RAI support for the generative models as well. So please stay tuned.
Amazing. Well, thank you so much for spending some time with us, Wenxin.
Thank you, Zaz.
Awesome. And thank you so much for watching. We've been talking all about responsible AI support for image and text models. Part one, we did text models. Stay tuned for part two, where we talk about image models. Thank you so much for watching, and hopefully we'll see you next time. Take care.